Following the success of Flight 10, SpaceX has been preparing its next booster for testing, leading to speculation that the launch could happen earlier than scheduled. If all goes well, it will be a milestone for SpaceX. Let's discuss all of this in today's episode of NR Studio. It's important to reiterate that SpaceX reached a new high with Flight 10. This achievement not only boosted confidence, but also raised expectations, suggesting that future missions might even surpass this success. Now it appears those hopes will soon be realized. Cameron County has revealed a new schedule for road closures between 12 a.m. and 4 a.m. Central Standard Time on September 6th. The schedule shows the movement of equipment from the production facility to the launch pad. Given the timing, the reason is quite clear. The Flight 11 booster is being prepared for testing. This booster, known as B-15, previously flew on Flight 8 alongside Flight 34. During that mission, B-15 was successfully captured by the launch tower's large suction arm, marking SpaceX's third successful capture attempt. The booster is now being prepared for its next flight, making it the second reused Starship booster after B-14, which successfully flew on Flight 7 and 9. According to the retirement schedule, B-15 is being placed in a transport bay set aside for this purpose. Since April 9, the booster has been in Mega Bay, undergoing repairs and inspections. Its recent movements suggest it is ready for its next launch. This also suggests that B-17 may not fly at all. It could be scrapped, upgraded to a new model, or reused for ground testing. Instead, B-15 has been modified and upgraded over the past 5 months. Repairs are believed to be complete, and previously problematic engines have likely been replaced. For example, during the boost back burn on Flight 8, two center ring engines failed, with one engine failing completely and the other recovering during the landing burn. With the replacement of these engines and the possibility of further upgrades, B-15 is now one of the most advanced and tested boosters in the lineup. This is important because the challenge level for Flight 11 is expected to increase. SpaceX may test steeper landing angles or push other performance boundaries. Currently, B-15 has been moved directly to the launch pad and is sitting between helicopters, indicating that it will soon be lifted onto the orbital mount. This schedule aligns with Starbase City's announced beach closure schedule, which is set for 5 a.m. to 12 p.m. on September 7th. This timing likely indicates significant static fire testing for B-15, and this is where the real excitement begins.
Preparation and testing are underway just 11 to 12 days after the 10th flight, less than 2 weeks. This sets a new record for Starship operations and demonstrates that SpaceX has significantly accelerated its turnaround time, achieving levels previously thought impossible. So what does this mean in practice? It suggests that SpaceX has likely renovated the launch pad in record time. The 10th flight not only went flawlessly, but also left the pad in excellent condition. Some observers have noted potential issues with the BQD and SQD systems, but if any damage did occur, SpaceX clearly repaired it quickly. This efficiency allows the B-15 to launch much earlier than expected. During the static fire test, the B-15 will almost certainly fire all 33 Raptor engines to assess the condition of the refurbished and newly installed engines. Following this test, the booster will return to the production site for final inspection. At that point, SpaceX will add the hot staging ring and finalize the FTS system before declaring it ready for launch. Meanwhile, after B-15 leaves the launch pad, a test stand will be prepared for Starship 38's static firing test. S-38 successfully completed cryogenic testing at the Sanchez site in late July and was recently fired up. This means the ship is nearly ready for its engine testing campaign. The timeline suggests S-38 could complete the static firing test in the second half of this month and then return to the production site for installation and checks. This schedule would allow it to meet B-15 on the launch pad shortly thereafter. Given the current pace, SpaceX could be ready for a launch by the end of September. If not, early October would be a reasonable next target. Regardless, the company is working hard to maintain the momentum. If Flight 11 does indeed launch in September, it would mark the first instance of Starship flying in 2 consecutive months. Remarkably, it could surpass the existing turnaround record of 37 days set between Flights 5 and 6. This record would be broken if the next launch occurs before October 3. However, even if the record isn't broken, a flight in late September or early October would represent a significant improvement in launch frequency, especially considering previous setbacks this year. So now, the question is simple. Do you believe the 11th flight will take place this month? Please share your thoughts in the comments with a yes or no answer and include your estimated launch date. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to stay up to date on SpaceX's incredible journey with Starship. Without a doubt, the 11th flight will be a crucial mission, marking the final flight of the V2 series, which will involve more challenging tests than those encountered on the 10th flight. The spacecraft will attempt sharper angles of attack, perform active flips.
Although recent Starship simulations conducted at the Star Factory indicate that the payload capacity may be increased to 20, SpaceX will continue its testing to restart the engines in space and improve the heat shield. Both phases are expected to focus on executing a controlled landing, with SpaceX likely aiming to increase post-landing survival time rather than facing a rapid collapse. These initiatives will pave the way for V3. If successful, they will accelerate the launch schedule and keep the first flight scheduled for the end of the year. Looking further ahead, the results of Flight 11 will influence when Starship landing attempts can be made. According to Musk, SpaceX may attempt landings from flights 13 to 15, depending on the performance of the V3 flight. While not explicitly stated, this mission will be crucial. Therefore, let's extend our best wishes to Starship and the SpaceX team as they embark on this important journey. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next one.